Boston Rob has proven his ability to help a tribe not only in challenges, but in camp life. He has played three times. He's made it to the final once. He has never won.
Originally, I wanted to vote Francesca off because the very first time I met her, she stood up on the mat, looked at Jeff and said, I don't want to play with him because he's too sneaky. She knows my game. So I don't want someone like that on my tribe.
First person voted out of Survivor Redemption Island. Francesca.
Matt's trying to play the good guy, but Andrea knows what she wants. And if she can have her little puppy dog along for the ride, she's gonna walk him. She's gonna walk him all over this island. And for me, that's not good because I know how strong a pair can be in this game. Like Amber and I.
But now I'm thinking about who I'm gonna sit next to at the end. I think Natalie's a perfect partner at this point. But it's gonna be hard though. It's like literally picking the girl up, putting her on my back, and I'm gonna drag your ass to the end. And hopefully they're gonna give it to me at the end.
What is he doing?
Matt shaking the opposition's hand after we lost the challenge is despicable. When we just got our asses kicked, not once, but twice, back to back, I'm not going over to the other team and giving them hugs and kisses. But Matt's getting four votes. I didn't want to play Survivor like this. I really didn't. I wanted to keep my team strong. I mean, I get it. Matt's playing Survivor. He's playing textbook. But he's playing with me. I literally have to wait until 1 minute before we go to Tribal Council. I may actually even have to tell him at Tribal Council who to vote for, because Philip likes to talk a lot.
He's liable to run around and tell everybody in the group everything we're doing.
So here's the deal. When the time comes to vote, I'm gonna take my right hand and put it on the shoulder of the person I want you to vote for.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Okay.
This will be a good test to see if Philip does what he says he's gonna do. And if he does, he can start to earn his way back into the rotation. If I get there tonight and Philip starts telling everybody what I told him, Philip will be sent packing.
Second person voted out of Survivor Redemption Island, Matt.
This night could not have gone any better. Not only do we blindside Matt, we're able to have Christina get rid of her immunity idol. And Philip was a loyal soldier.
Okay. There's obviously an alliance.
Right.
The two girls, Natalie and Ashley.
Yep.
And me and Grant.
You two, yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
You'll fit.
Okay, that's cool. You won't even see me flip-flopping here.
Yeah.
When I shake my hand, when I do that right there, my word is my bond.
I look over and I see Philip's fat ass bending the chair about to break it. I look down at the hidden immunity idol clue. It's right underneath his ass. It's sitting sewn inside the fabric of the chair.
How lucky was that?
Had Philip not been so fat, that chair wouldn't have been bending as much and I wouldn't have told him to move. But I don't plan on telling anybody about the clue because I want the idol for me. Philip is a piece of work. I mean, who comes on Survivor and wears pink tidy whities with the stuff just hanging out and, you know, just flopping around everywhere? It's not only disturbing, it's actually disgusting. It's like your dad should have bought a new pair, like, months ago. You don't want your friends coming over to play and seeing that. While Philip and Christina were away at the duel today, I started thinking, I need to find the hidden immunity idol before Christina finds it again. I already have the clue, and I had a good idea that it was on this side of camp, and I needed to get everybody out of camp for the day. So, I created this game, we're calling it Royal Treatment. The winner gets whatever they want. You can get your rice served to you by whoever you want. So, I'm trying to think, how am I gonna get away from everybody after I'm the one that planned this whole beach day?
Stomach's bothering me a little bit, too.
It is?
Maybe like constipated?
Oh, no.
So I tell him I'm having a little bit of trouble moving things down in that area, you know, and I feel like something might be happening. So I bring him to the nice part of the beach where the sand is really nice. And immediately, Grant heads into the ocean. Perfect. I don't have to even look Grant in the eye. I don't have to make an excuse. They'll cover for me. So I look at the girls. I said, it's time. I gotta try to relieve myself. Ding, ding. There's a winner. Baby, maybe I learned something since last time.
As for my plans for it, right now, I'm not sure.
Do you feel better?
I don't want to talk about it. But one thing I do know is that with this immunity, Heidel, this time I'm going to make it 39 days and win. Apparently, Christina's been snooping around about the idol. She's dangerous. As much as everybody else hates Philip and doesn't trust Philip, he's less of a threat to me than Christina is.
Yeah.
I don't want to give it away that I have the idol. I want them to think Christina has it. So we're going to split the vote. We're going to throw 3 votes on Christina, 2 votes on Philip. And if everybody does what they're told, Christina will be voted out.
4th person voted out of Survivor Redemption Island. Christina.
Philip is bugging everyone, including myself. He's completely off his rocker, walking around in his pink panties. Nobody trusts them.
It's like seriously hurting my eyes.
As long as Philip is aggravating everybody so much, it takes all the heat off of me. So in a way, maybe he needs to stay. Philip was right. I mean, the girls weren't doing anything. But the less they do, the happier I am. I don't want them working hard and, you know, giving us a reason to write your name down to win $1 million at the end of this thing. I want you to annoy the crap out of everyone as much as possible. Marilonio? Marilonio doesn't mean anything. It's just an inside joke between Amber and I. She has a bunch of stuffed animals, and Marilonio is like the ringleader. So that's the name of our new tribe.
1, 2, 3, Marilonio!
There's like a Christian coalition brewing here in Nicaragua. Look, I got nothing against God. I mean, I go to church on Sunday, but anytime a group of individuals like the same thing, I don't like that. It could be romantic comedies, it could be Oreo cookies. If they're all liking it together, I want that broken up. Matt just told me he was thinking about flipping and going with Zapatero. I mean, first of all, he has the audacity to think that he's gonna come up with a plan to vote me out. And then the stupidity to tell me that. It just confirmed he can't be trusted. So because of that, I'm giving him a one-way ticket back to Redemption Island.
8th person voted out of Survivor Redemption Island. Matt.
From here on out, we don't decide who's going next until the very last minute.
Yes.
We're going to do the buddy system. Nobody talks to anybody on their own.
Don't even friggin' entertain any crap with them.
No conversation about it.
No, we
just the weather and
we're
boy,
guaranteed to go to the final six.
I have a whole vision that I'm trying to put into action here. Keep an us versus them mentality. Thus the separate shelters, the separate eating times. I want my group to hate Zapatero. It's us versus them, and we're better than them. And we're gonna be arrogant about it, and we're gonna show it. I'm not, but I want them to. Because I want their votes at the end of the day. So Natalie just came and told me that Ralph approached Ashley and said that if she makes it to the top 3 that he's voting for her. He's doing that so that Ashley makes a case to not vote off Ralph. He may have voted his ass off anyway. Okay, he's not gonna vote for me, Ralph? Well, you're not gonna vote for Ashley. But she ain't gonna be there now. And it's your fault. Ashley, you could have made it to the end, but you decided not to tell me anything. You have to tell me everything. It's my game. I'm in charge.
I'm still thinking about my end game and the jury. So, as far as Philip and I go, Philip's at the top of my list. He's my number one. That's all he needs to know. So, Natalie and Philip come to the final throw with me.
Here's the thing. I'm running my tribe like the army. I'm the general. They're soldiers, and they're all doing as they're told.
Rob has it. Rob wins immunity.
Steve is bringing up Survivor All-Stars, in which if you're a Survivor fan, you know that Rob made an alliance with Amber that took her all the way to the end, and she beat him. There was one critical moment where he needed help from somebody, and after he got the help, he cut his throat. The other side of the coin is that he didn't betray Amber. In fact, he hasn't betrayed her since. Rob, hard to deny the history. You betrayed Lex, but you stayed true to the true alliance that you made with Amber.
The one I still have to this day.
Rob wins immunity.
I got 8 days left. 8 days. I just gotta keep everybody happy. And as long as they don't stop talking to each other and realize that I'm the one that should be going, I'll be all set. And I feel like right now I'm playing my best game. But even everything that's happened up until right now, means nothing unless I can finish it. I need this. It's to make a better life for my wife and my kids. Even though we're at a point now where some people might be taking a break from the game and thinking about home, it just makes me focus. I want to win Survivor. This is something I've been trying to do for 10 years now. I'm 8 days away, so there's nothing that's gonna stop me. My sister gave me a shirt with Amber and my daughter Lucia on it, and I'm gonna work my ass off to make sure Andrea doesn't win immunity.
Rob falls to the top. Mariana wins immunity.
You all right, Rob?
Oh, it's hot. My legs are burning. I'll live, dude. Let's go.
No.
Oh, okay.
Oh. Ah. Physically, the challenge, I had to literally give everything I have. Afterwards, I thought I was gonna die. But I figure that I'm 7 days away, and I'm giving it everything I got. Andrea's a competitor. If she sits at the end, she could possibly beat me.
14th person voted out. Andrew.
Days like today, man, I wish I stayed home. It just happens that, you know, when there's one thing you don't want to happen, it happened. Grant, when you watch this, you're gonna realize I never wanted to do it this way, bud. And although I'd like to, you know, think of you as a friend, I didn't come to this game to make friends. I came to this game to win. So even though it does break my heart, bud, I gotta vote your ass off tonight. One man should not have this much power in this game. Luckily, I'm not an ordinary man.
Rob, a few more days left in this game. What gets you through this?
My wife and my daughter. That's it. I love my wife more than anything else in the world. And she knows how much I love this game. She's made tremendous sacrifices to let me come out here over and over and over again to try to win. And we're so close, but with all the different scenarios, we're still so friggin' far away. I mean, you can try to do everything right the whole game, and then one little thing here or there, and poof, it's all gone.
15th person voted out. Grant.
Ashley won, so Andrea goes home. Sorry, Andrea, you're next.
If anybody has a hidden immunity idol and you want to play it, tonight is the last night you can do so.
You know what? My mother always told me that it'll be safe than sorry. There you go.
16th person voted out. Andrea.
10 years, 4 times on Survivor, 116 days, 1 challenge for $1 million. That's what it comes down to. It's pretty big stakes.
Only you are safe. He is. Yeah! Rob Moreno wins final immunity. Woo!
Good job, Ashley. Beat it up here.
Boston Rob, come on over. When you needed it, you got it.
Thank you.
That was beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
Good job.
Rob, safe tonight at the final tribal council. This means you are guaranteed a spot at that final tribal council where you will get a chance to plead your case about why, after 4 times playing, you deserve to win. The big question this afternoon, who's going home? Who's going to the final? Grab your stuff, head back to camp. I'll see you at tribal tonight.
Thanks.
Congrats.
Yeah, thanks.
It was Amber that encouraged me to come back and try again. She believes in me. It's because of her. Like, whatever happens now, I'm okay. Even if I don't win. Which is ironic, because the only reason I ever wanted to come back and play again was to win, but I feel like I did my best.
Wow. 39 days in Nicaragua, 117 days total over the last 10 years. It's overwhelming. Winning this game has always eluded me. And again, I find myself one step away from the top, and I'm just hoping to get there.
The juries can be funny sometimes. They try to make me cry. And you know what I did last time? I felt bad. And I said, I'm sorry. And you know what? Looking back in it, that's the biggest regret I ever had. I should have stood up and said, hey, kiss my ass.
And twice, you know, I made it all the way to the end. The first time, the jury didn't feel I was worthy. I'm hoping that tonight I'm not going to screw it up again. As far as I'm concerned, I've done my job.
I think the biggest thing I've learned through this, being my fourth time, is that I need to stop playing games. It's time to put it to rest. This is the last day I will ever play. At this point, I need to go home and take care of my wife and my children. That's nice. What I'm going to do.
And now for something completely different. I'm not going to ask you guys any questions. I'm not even going to talk to you. I'm going to talk to them. There's really only one logical decision here. Well, one person doesn't deserve it, so we can cut him off. The other one thanked somebody for doing it all. Who'd she thank? The guy sitting in the middle. He did everything. And most importantly, he managed to blindside Matt. And in the process of doing that, he sent a message to his tribe that if any of you show any signs not being loyal, you're going to go home. He controlled all of you. He controlled your minds. He controlled what you did. He controlled your thoughts. You all bought it. And one by one by one, all of you were blindsided. A little ruthless, but brilliant. When we started this game, two people came in. One of them claimed to be the best to ever play the game. He walked out on day 8. There's a guy sitting over there that just played the best strategic game this game has ever seen. And it's pretty damn easy to tell you who deserves to get your vote tonight.
The winner of Survivor Redemption Island.